you've already got it set up. Okay.
You want a picture of yourself?
Oh, sure. The biker in Minnehaha? Sure. Well, how about on this side? I used to bike here all the time, so I came back for old times sake. But how are you going to get it to me?
Huh? How are you going to get it to you? On the internet.
Oh, I guess. Okay. Okay.
I was going to take my shirt off and I thought, nah, you're...
Well, you're hot and sweaty, so.
Yeah, but I'm getting too old. I'm old and puffy in the last couple of
years. Yeah. Okay, have you taken the picture yet?
Yeah, that's the word. It's a movie.
Oh, it is. Okay, I'm Laura.
I'm David.
David, yeah.
I've seen you here before.
Well, it's been about 4 years.
Oh, has it?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought, well, there must be some other lady that bikes. Did you bike today?
No, I drove. I don't have my bike with me. I live in Oregon.
Oh, okay.
So I came back to visit my family here. And I keep telling them out in Oregon that the fish and chips are the best at sea salt. And they go, So I came here just to see.
Really?
Well, you know, this is walleye, and back there it's cod.
So it's fish and chips with walleye.
Yeah, I think that's the difference. They're very good.
Oh, yeah, I had to try it. I didn't know that. I thought it was good to cut.
I don't think so. I think this is walleye.
Yeah, I think it is too.
Yeah,
I know they had walleye on the menu. I get their shrimp cocktails.
Oh, that sounds good.
The shrimp cocktail. It's got unbreaded shrimp. Just steamed and chilled shrimp with a double thing of corn,
soft shell. Kind of
soft shell.
Oh, yeah. Cool. Where are you riding from?
I'm riding from downtown.
Oh, are you? Yeah. To St. Paul?
From downtown Minneapolis, I ride out here.
Oh, do you?
They have a path that comes out and comes up to where Lake Street is.
Yeah.
Well, they took out the railroad tracks. There used to be railroad tracks going parallel from all the way from the lakes, all the way to the river.
Ah.
Parallels. So it would be like 29th Street, and I think 30th would be Lake Street.
Oh, yeah.
So they have a double thing in there, and they took out the tracks and put in a bike path. So it goes underneath all the things all the way through.
Wow, nice. No stop signs, no traffic.
Well, there is a few places. Uh-huh. And they still have a train on part of it. And so they have to stop for the train, too. But I wish they would have left the stop signs in for the... So everybody would always have to stop for the railroad tracks. But they took them out for those automatic ones, where they only flip to stop them when there's a train. Of course, yeah, that's really important stuff. They should have done that just as long as well. Because they got a bike path there, you might as well say, just always stop.
Yeah.
I got hit there a couple
times.
Did
you?
Yeah.
By what?
Car. I'm throwing a cell phone. It broke my head.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
That's
terrible.
Well,
actually, it broke my bone right below the head, so I didn't end up with a broken hip, so I recovered.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. That's terrible. You had to go to the hospital and have hip surgery.
Oh, yeah.
Did you have a replacement?
Get a lawyer to sue her, and then the lawyer let her off.
Oh, really?
So it was my fault.
Oh, really?
Even though she came to a complete stop for the bike path, she was actually on her cell phone. So as soon as she was done, she stepped on the gas and looked up and saw me.
Laying in the street?
Yeah, after she hit me, I think she had a daughter with her. Her daughter must have screamed bloody murder. I mean, because she said... She had to back away from the scene because her daughter was coming nuts. Her daughter was only like, 7-year-old kid that she just picked up from school or something.
Oh, wow. That's traumatizing. Mom hit somebody on the bike.
That'd be a nightmare for the rest of your life.
Yeah. So you just ride over here for a beer?
Yeah, it's a bad habit. Well, last time I was here,
I used to stop here for fish and chips and a couple of beers and drive back to, I lived in St. Paul, so we would go back to the lakes and go around the lakes and go back to
place at home. Yeah, it didn't make me a very good bike maker. Yeah, and the Sunday morning before my kids were up, I lived up a snowing in Highland there, and I'd drive over and go around, visit Nicomas and then Cedar. I can't remember what the roads are, but in order, Cedar was last. Mom, what's your hand for breakfast? Yeah. It's a good biking. Very little biking in Oregon.
That's too bad.
Yeah, it is. The rails to trails here, we used to go down to Cannon Valley and drive right on the
road. Did you ever ride up the, where is the one in St. Paul? Gateway Trail goes all the way up to Seattle.
Yeah.
I used to do that. I used to go out there and they have their little fisherman on the river.
Oh, what's
it outside like this?
Yeah.
On the river. And then I had for lunch they had baby back ribs for $5. And you could get a pitcher of beer for about $2.50. So I'd sit there and drink a pitcher of beer and have my ribs. I'd have to haul
then
my ass off
and get back. Oh my gosh.
We live in downtown Minneapolis.
I'm a
high rise that overlooks downtown. And I can see Loring Park. So I got the lake and everything. I got some of the best shots. I got living on the 18th floor of on the 19th floor of the 20th story. Oh, I got a beautiful view.
Then you must be some sort of a camera person.
Yeah, I have newfangled things, you know, those quadcopters.
Like a
DJI.
They go up in the air. Like
servicemen.
Drones, yeah.
They're scary. I got one, it's a real nice one. It's made by DJI, and it's kind of hard to see the thing because you're supposed to use your phone with it, you know, how you can't see your phone. So I got a new screen that was really super bright that I bought on the remote control. I also bought a helmet that you can put on too, and then you can look right up at the camera can see. I thought that was going to be the perfect thing. But they said you shouldn't be doing that either because then you can't watch your copter. I go, what do you mean you can't watch it? I can see right where it's going.
I can see what it sees.
Yeah.
Wow.
I can't get any better than that.
Yeah.
But not only that, but these things have, if you back into something, it'll stop. If you go to run into something, it has sensors all around it. Underneath it, I don't think it has one up. You can probably go up and smack into something. I think there's one on top. But you can, but if you start getting close to like a tree or something, it'll start beeping that's getting close to it.
Like you're walking into a tree.
And it'll stop, it won't go anywhere. But the thing is that the cherry at the walker, cherry on the spoon.
Oh yeah.
I filmed that. It had a remote control thing on here where it's called it's kind of like an ellipse.
Oh.
So you got the thing in the viewfinder. And you tell it to take off. It goes out, it goes around the thing and looks, keeps on focusing on it. So it goes around it, it's always looking at it. But it goes out of the lips, it goes up, way up in the air like that, and then comes down and goes around and comes back to where it started. I did that right when it was just about sunset. So there's lights all over the park and stuff. Then I brought it to YouTube and put it on the internet, and I got some music off of YouTube that lets you have royalty free to go with it.
How many hits did you get?
I don't think I even got that many because people don't know what it is.
Yeah, I didn't know that's cool.
But even if I brought my cell phone today, they don't have any cell phone service. But it's under Innerlocus on YouTube.
It's on what?
Under Innerlocus.
Locus. Yes, like the locus.
Yeah, like the psychological thing called innerlocus of control.
That's
where I got the idea. Innerlocus from my YouTube site. So I got that one on there, and I did a few other ones that it can do. This thing can zoom in, so it does like an Alfred Hitchcock shot. That's where, like, in Vertigo, they showed down the steps, and it made it look like the steps are just expanding out because Jimmy Stewart would push out Vertigo.
Oh, yeah.
And he was, you know, went like this when you look down the steps, and they kind of like look like they expand up. But they call that a dolly zoom. They pull back on the camera and zoom in at the same time, and that just makes the structure that you're looking at kind of stretch out. So I was on the Walker Bridge over there by the park in the middle of the night.
In the middle of the night?
Well, it was dark out, uh-huh. And there's traffic going underneath the bridge. And I had it right out in front of me, and I said, you know, for it to go ahead and do the dolly zoom. So it starts backing up all by itself, and it doesn't sound like that. Backs up and zooms in as it pulls away, and sure enough, the whole bridge looks like it's expanding. And it's got those zigzag, you know, beams throughout the whole thing. It just looks like the thing is, you know, pulling apart. It's really cool. And I name it the Dolly Zoom too. I got that one on my side. I don't have too many things on here, but I got that. But one of them that I did too is over by Lake of the Isles at the north end of it. I just went up as high as it would go, which is 400 feet up in the air. And I'm looking out over Lake of the Isles, and you can see Lake Calhoun, yeah. And Lake Hyatt. Even a little teeny bit of Lake Hyatt, you know that. What's in the water way up there? It's got to be Lake Hyatt. Huh. And then all of a sudden, yeah, I just brought it down as fast as possible, and I'm filming on it. So you just get this zoom shot, and it's that far. So you can see the lake and everything, and you're coming down, and there's lights sparkling off the water.
Wow.
And you're coming down, you see these, this is Lake of the Isles, you're coming down on top of. You can see the streets on both sides, there's cars, people walking, and there's fall trees and all these beautiful houses. It is coming straight down, and it comes down, it's just about head high, and it comes down, it goes like this way, and senses the ground. It does this like a little bump because it knew that it had to stop. And it came down and then came back up a little bit and leveled off. Huh. Then it starts trimming a little bit. You can see my back wheel of my bike in the picture a little bit. And that's the end of it. Huh. That was a fun one too. And that was like the first time I ever had that. They even take it out that much. That's true. Huh. Not for any good shots on it.
Yeah, that sounds really good.
Yeah, that's a lot of fun. So you're right, I do like cameras.
Yeah.
Where I let the mountain right up here too.
Oh, to watch where you're going. You film where you're going?
Well, sometimes I just have it filming me. So I can see me on the bike. That's the way I had it when that rain hit.
Oh, and you were filming it?
I was filming it, so I even have it on film. I could have sued her for a lot of money.
Yeah.
My lawyer let her go.
How come?
Why didn't I fire him? I could tell.
You need a personal injury lawyer.
But he was supposed to be, but I had to ask him a couple of times, are you sure you're not gonna have some interest with, you know, farmers insurance? The thing is, I come from a dysfunctional family, and I think that's one of the biggest things that it showed me is that, you know, effects of your dysfunctional family allowing him to do that, knowing that he was leading me down this path. He was telling me all the way that he was not gonna be on my side.
He was not gonna be on your side?
Well, he didn't say it to me right off, but he was doing things.
Oh.
He sent me to doctor appointments that didn't exist. And he said that, that farmer's insurance. I go, it's not farmer's insurance. That was your insurance. Why would you give me a thing that you didn't check out? I had to check it, it was like the second one. I go, why did he send me to a second one? And how come it's not the same hospital? Well, the one that they gave me first time was called Minneapolis, and then this next one was way out somewhere. Got this and so on. And there's a little bunch of hints like that. I tell you, when you think back, when you get 20/20 vision on this stuff, and you can, and you can see
always
all
high
the
vision
hints,
is, you know,
all the red flags.
Yeah. High vision is always 20/20.
The thing is that I have to try not to beat myself up and think, you know, you won the lottery with this thing just by realizing how much your family affected you growing up, and it's still there.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Not taking care of yourself.
I'm trying to.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's a lot of fallout that's still hanging around, and it's not easy to do.
Good luck with that, David.
Oh,
no,
that's
I'm going to go meet my grandkids for dinner.
Oh, that sounds good.
I just have the children's portions.